Good morning. This is East by Northwest Hiking, and I have a brand new bag. This is the Aegis Max Summit 1, and this just might be the best budget shoulder season bag out there. Let me put some pants on, and I'll come outside and tell you why. So here we have it. This is the Summit Series bag from Aegis Max. This is a brand new series of bags. So this is the Summit 1 that I purchased. They also have a Summit 2. The difference between these two bags is going to be the amount of fill in them and thus the amount of warmth. This particular bag, I did a lot of research on. I have an old REI bag that weighs 4 pounds. It's a synthetic bag, and it was rated at 15 degrees Fahrenheit, but it was not keeping me warm down to even 45 degrees. And to give you a little background on myself, I am not a big guy. I've seen a ton of backpacking reviews online, and people will say this bag will keep me warm down to some crazy temperature rating, and yet these are very large, you know, 200 pound, 6 foot tall guys. I am 5 foot nine. I weigh 140 pounds. I sleep quite cold. So I need a warmer bag in order to keep from freezing each night, and I also generally need more clothes. But I came across this bag and it was very interesting to me. As for fit and finish, this bag is probably a 10 out of 10. I have looked it over several times. I cannot find a single thread that's sticking out. Everything has been trimmed perfectly. In fact, there was like 3 feathers that might have popped out the first night I used it, which kind of blew my mind, honestly. I've never had a down product that hasn't you know, had more feathers come out right away. So fit and finish is definitely right up there with any kind of cottage company that you might expect. As for the zipper, I appreciate that, as you can see here, it goes down almost to the foot, so you could realistically use this like a quilt when it gets hotter in the summertime, and that could really extend that that kind of usable temperature range of this bag, because it is an incredibly warm bag. When it comes to warmth on this bag, it is actually EN rated at 30 degrees Fahrenheit, or minus 2, give or take, minus 1, I guess, technically, degrees Celsius. So this is a perfect, I'm gonna call it sort of a, at least in my area, a 2.5 season bag, because it's not quite gonna keep me warm in the dead of winter, but it's gonna be too much for the summer. However, it is April now. Last night was about 37-ish degrees. I think the forecast was for 38. And it is chilly this morning. I'm actually cold here in this fleece. But I was so toasty in this bag. And I can only take that into account for the, you know, amazing down-filling that it has. As for its price point, this guy comes in right around $200. From AliExpress, and I know a lot of people don't like to order off of AliExpress because it takes longer to get here, but I can say that even it being 2022 and we hear about these shipping issues here and there, this bag only took 2 weeks to get here. That's the fastest I've ever received a product from AliExpress. Typically, I expect them to take about a month to get here, so I was really impressed at the shipping time. So Aegis Max makes a bag called the M3. And it is actually a hair lighter than this bag and a hair warmer than this bag. So why would I buy this over that bag? Well, it came down to a couple factors for me. First of all, this bag is actually made out of a slightly different fabric. This bag has a 20 denier nylon fabric on the outside, and I believe it's also a 20 denier fabric on the inside. And I can tell you right now, the feel of this fabric is very, very nice. It's quiet, relatively, and it has a really nice smooth inside that does not feel like a trash bag, which was one of the top complaints of the M3. The outer fabric does claim to have a durable water repellent on it, and I find that to be true. On the colder nights, I have sort of cinched up there, which means my breath is sort of coming out on it. And, you know, at first I thought that was almost a gimmick to bags, but when I breathe all night and I noticed all my condensation
up here on the top of the bag, and it wasn't actually making the bag wet, which is really, really critical for down. You really want to try to avoid getting your down wet at all costs. So having that on there was also a, you know, just great aspect to have on the bag. When I got this bag, I could tell the down was really thick, and you can still see it's kind of thick. Up in the hood, up by the chest area, and then it was fairly thick down by the foot, but right in the middle, it kind of looked like that. And the very first night I used it, I could actually feel that right in sort of my crotch and upper leg area was a little bit cold. And between a couple messages with Aegis Max, as well as just doing some, you know, probing myself, I figured out that this bag has an incredibly clever baffling system. So it has baffles going across it, but they are not all the way across. They're actually open on the very edges, and that goes for the top of the bag and the bottom of the bag. And so what you can actually do is shake the bag and shake the down towards the foot box, towards the middle, towards the top. And then also they claim to have the down as a sort of 40-60 distribution, where 40% of the down is on the bottom and 60% of it is on the top. I personally would like a little bit more on the top. So I also figured out that right at the hood area, the baffles also connect from the top to the bottom. So it took me about 5 minutes of some pretty vigorous shaking, but I was able to essentially shake a lot of the down towards the hood and then shake it from the bottom to the top and then redistribute that down towards the middle of the bag. And now it seems to have an excellent distribution, excellent warmth quality. And I mean, as you can see, just the loft on this bag for a $200 bag is absolutely phenomenal. I would say the only real con to this bag has really nothing to do with its quality as much as its just overall design. It's a snug bag, and I'm a small person. So I think if you are a larger person, I think if you are, you know, in that 6 foot plus range, 200 pounds plus, you might find that this bag's a little bit cramped and a little bit claustrophobic. And in a down bag, you really don't want to be squishing up against it, because you're going to squish that down. You're going to lose all your insulation. This bag is also really designed for a back sleeper. I have been teaching myself how to be a back sleeper, but what will happen is if you roll over, if you try to spread your legs, you will compress that down. You'll lose its insulative properties, and it'll get cold. I mean, if I kind of squish up my butt against it, if I roll over to my side, I'll notice within a couple minutes my butt will start getting cold. But that's nothing really wrong with the bag. That's just the nature of, you know, your high fill power downs. Well, that sums up my review of the Aegis Max Summit 1 sleeping bag. If you have found that some cool budget gear that has just been surprisingly good quality, please let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, if you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel. And we'll see you, I guess, on the next review, maybe on a hike. I don't really know. I'm just getting this guy started. So thanks again, and we'll see you on a trail. The Aegis Max Summit Series sleeping bag. Wait for those guys to stop. You done? Nope, now the other ones are going. I come out in the woods to get a little peace and quiet, and this is what I get.